From the Tribune News Network, this is News Break. I'm Kirk Smith. Tuesday's top story is a shot on the arm for the tourism industry as that sector tries to rebound from the impact of the coronavirus. British Airways has now resumed direct flights to the country after being suspended for a while. That is good news for tourism officials. It's a once-weekly flight for now, but Tourism Minister D'Angelo says it's at least a start. Immigration Minister Johnson reacting to that recent United Nations fact-finding visit to the country. The UN delegation visited the Carmichael Road Detention Center and the farm shanty town in Abaco. Minister Johnson telling the Tribune the government welcomed that inspection visit because the country has nothing to hide. That delegation released a statement thanking the government for its hospitality and promised help on immigration matters going forward. The overall shantytown issue remains before the courts.
So the issue is not to stop or not to stop. This issue is being litigated by the courts, and we let it litigate with the courts. The issue is how do we work with the government and different stakeholders to ensure that whatever solution comes out of it, the fundamental human rights of people, the fundamental dignity of people is always respected.
No court decision announced this yet. This is Newsbreak from the Tribune News Network. Police now working the latest murder case. A 35-year-old man shot and killed on Washington Street here in the Capitol Sunday night. The victim identified by relatives as Alfred Lightburn Jr. That shooting late Sunday night. Police are not sure of the motive at this point. Two men in custody following a major drug bust in the Exuma Keys. The men taken into custody following a short boat chase. Agents found an estimated $1 million worth of marijuana on that boat. Three new Supreme Court justices now in place. Andrew Forbes, Jeannie Weish Gomez, and Juanita Lewis Johnson sworn in yesterday. Latest coronavirus numbers, another jump for Sunday. 58 total cases for the country, 40 of them in the capital. Cat Island and Ross Grand Bahama and Bimini also reporting cases. 55 persons in hospital, 5 in the ICU. No other deaths have been reported. Hurricane season officially underway. Begins today. Anna is the first name on the list, already gone. The next storm will be called Bill. Details of the day's top stories in the Tribune newspaper on the streets first thing in the morning. Stay up to date online at Tribune242.com. Now the Tribune's AccuWeather update, a service of insurance management. That frontal system is now stationary across Florida. Still sending some weather this way. Mostly cloudy, showers around, highs in the mid-80s. 84 at Freeport, 84 in the Capitol, 86 at Matthewtown. No marine advisories, winds generally 10 to 15 knots, the seas 2 to 4 feet. Low tide now, the next high around 2 this afternoon. Mostly cloudy skies tonight, lows from the mid to upper 70s. Showers could still be in the area. No systems in the tropics on the first day of the hurricane season. If you need additional weather information, check the Tribune's weather page. For your insurance needs, call Insurance Management. We're now in the hurricane season. Insurance Management urges you to complete your preparations and ensure that your home and contents coverage is up to date. Call them today. With more than 40 years in business, nobody does it better than Insurance Management. This is Newsbreak from the Tribune News Network.
Let the Bahamas and the world know that you're open for business by advertising in the Tribune and on Tribune242.com. Reach the market that'll get your cash registers ringing by calling 502-2394 today. Our professional advertising agents are on hand to customize packages just for you, and consultations are free. Give your business the maximum exposure for an affordable investment, and let us help you increase your sales. Call 502-2394 today. We're open for business. Let the world know you are too. The Tribune, the People's Paper, biggest and best.
Tuesday's World News headlines: another kidnapping in Nigeria. Gunmen have taken dozens of children from a school. The government is trying to find them. U.S. President Biden says democracy is in peril in a Memorial Day speech honoring America's war dead. China is now facing a population crisis and has now increased the children quota. Families can now have up to 3 children. It was 2 before. The Tribune's gas tracker prices for Tuesday: Shell $4.91, SO $5.01, Rubus $5.01 per gallon in the capital. Now your sports notes, brought to you by the Tribune Sports Section. A report on Donald Thomas, the high jumper who hasn't been in the news lately. Find out what he is doing to get back in the swing of things. There's an update on the French Open tennis tournament Find out why Naomi Osaka is out. Get details of last night's NBA playoff games. DeAndre Ayton and the Suns take on the Lakers in game number 5 tonight. Jonquel Jones and the Sun did not play last night in the WNBA. Jazz and the Marlins opening a series in Toronto today. Get the latest Major League Baseball news in the Tribune Sports Tuesday. For all of your sports details, you want to check the Tribune Sports section. Everything you need from the world of sports you'll find in the Tribune Sports. And that's your news break. Details of the day's top stories in the Tribune newspaper on the streets first thing in the morning. Stay up to date online at Tribune242.com.